Greetings, everyone. I am Dr. Cataldo Leone, and as Dean at Interim, I have the honor and privilege of presiding over today's commencement convocation of the Henry M. Goldman School of Dental Medicine, to which I will refer to as GSDM during this proceeding. Dear graduates, I welcome you, your families and friends, and all members of the school community who are tuning in today. Today's virtual format is different from more traditional in-person formats, but it in no way diminishes the achievements of you, our graduates, as we bestow upon you your hard-earned and well-deserved degrees and certificates. Before continuing our program, I wish to recognize those individuals gathered here on the platform with me. Dr. Joseph Calabrese, Associate Dean of Students, Dr. John Garante, Associate Dean for Clinical Affairs, Dr. Celeste Kong, Chair of the Department of General Dentistry, Dr. Afsheen Lakhani, Clinical Associate Professor of General Dentistry, Dr. Janet Peters, Clinical Professor of General Dentistry, Ms. Catherine Sarkis, Assistant Dean for Admissions at Interim, Reverend Robert Allen Hill, Boston University Chaplain and Dean of Boston University's Marsh Chapel, Ms. Julia Geaumont, DMD Valedictorian, and Dr. Luljeta, Isedisha, DMD Advanced Standing Valedictorian. At this time, please rise as I ask Reverend Hill to provide the invocation.
Dean Leone and gathered friends, we pause for a hymn of praise and a word of prayer. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into God's presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is He who has made us and not we ourselves. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him. Bless His name. For the Lord is good, His steadfast love endures forever, and His faithfulness to all generations. And our prayer. O Thou who hast brought us to the beginning of this new season, this hour of celebration, protect us, we pray, by Thy power. Grant that this day we fall into no sin nor run into any danger, but that all our doing and thinking and speaking might be ordered by Thy governance, to do always that which is acceptable in Thy sight. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Hill. Please be seated. Members of the class of 2021, our heartfelt congratulations to all of you. Your journey has been very busy and very active, and yet very hectic as well. You have each put in years of hard work and made many sacrifices to get to this point. We applaud your dedication and believe that when all is said and done, that you will agree that the journey has been fulfilling. For sure, there have been challenges. And I imagine that everyone tuning in today has COVID fatigue, so I will not embellish on what we already know. And yet, it is necessary for me to acknowledge and to thank you for helping us to travel both the new normal and old normal paths along this mutual journey. You have had to adapt to online instruction and countless hours of Zoom calls while working hard to achieve your clinical competencies, even as the patient treatment center was less than fully operational. And of course, let us not minimize the personal consequences of the pandemic. The time apart from family and friends, the worry that we had for those who came down with the virus, and the grief we felt for those who lost their lives. Notwithstanding all of this, it is also necessary for me to urge you to not let one year define all the years. I ask that you focus on what you have learned, on how much you have grown, and all the good friends and colleagues you have made during your time here. The school has endeavored to cultivate in you a mindset that embraces innovation and continuous improvement. Lean into this mindset, for it will ensure that you remain ever curious, that you will never cease aspiring to learn more, to do more, and to be more for your patients, for your community, and for your profession, all the while remembering that the same applies to your families and to yourselves. For the postdoctoral residents, thank you for remaining engaged all those late evenings, and for some of you, all those Friday afternoons in your respective courses. For the graduate research students, thank you for persevering in your projects, because we all know that research does not always go as planned. For the predoctoral students, thank you for successfully navigating a very full curriculum of didactic, preclinical, and clinical instruction. Further, you may recall that at your respective white coat ceremonies, I informed your parents, your families, your friends, that the school had utmost confidence that you would continue your due diligence in the second half of your program. I am very happy to say here today that you proved us right. So, whether you are in a clinical specialty program, a graduate research program, or a predoctoral dental program, you entered school with eagerness and aspirations to excel as oral health care practitioners, and you have achieved your goals. You did so in large part by being responsible for your own learning, including the care of all those patients, our fellow human beings, who put their trust in you. That responsibility is lifelong, as you all very well know. And I have no doubt that you are all up to honoring the professional commitment that your graduation now grants you and now requires of you. Your time at GSDM has been incredible. We have been truly enriched by your presence. You leave us as you came in, intelligent, talented, and dedicated individuals, and with considerably more knowledge, skills, and values than on day one. We thank you for letting us travel along with you on that journey. On behalf of the entire GSDM community of faculty, staff, and alumni, I again congratulate you on your tremendous achievement. You have definitely earned it. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce our two student speakers. Speaking first will be Dr. Luljeta Isedisha, who is a graduate of the University of Medicine Tirana Faculty of Dental Medicine in Tirana, Albania, where she received a Master of Science in Dentistry in 2015. Before enrolling at GSDM, her professional experience included practicing general dentistry in Tirana and dental assisting here in the United States. At GSDM, she has had numerous student leadership and community outreach experiences, and plans to return to practicing general dentistry after graduation here in the Boston area. We are honored to have such a distinguished valedictorian for our graduating DMD advanced standing class. Dr. Isedisha.
It is the honor of my life to be standing here today as the valedictorian of the amazing DMD Advanced Standing Class of 2021. Not even in the wildest dreams of a little Albanian girl born in a small village surrounded by mountains would I have imagined this day. To my parents, who believed in me from day one, and to my husband for his endless support, thank you for believing in my dreams and walking this journey with me. This achievement would have not been possible without you. 2 years ago, Boston University opened a new door for us, and while we came for the degree, we stayed for the family we found here. Through all the diversity that encompasses our class, it was astonishing to realize how similar we are, and no matter the differences in culture, we shared the same humanity. We opened our hearts and homes and extended our arms and souls to new connections. opened our minds and visions to new perspectives, and I'm graduating today a much wiser person because I carry with me the legacy and wisdom of all my colleagues. Unfortunately, we are having a commencement ceremony much different from what we had imagined when we started this journey. While the celebrations may be smaller, the enthusiasm is greater, and our achievements are in no way diminished, but are rather amplified by the resilience we have shown throughout the last year. Take the time to raise a toast for this incredible milestone we have achieved with your dearest ones, no matter where they are in the world. This is only the beginning, as all of us are gearing up for the next phase of our life with passion, perseverance, and dedication. On behalf of the graduating class, DMD Advanced Standing, I would like to express our heartfelt gratitude to our family and friends, without whom our achievements would have not been possible. Thank you to our dean, faculty, staff, and administration for helping nurture our success. Thank you to our patients for giving us the opportunity to provide care to them and gain knowledge in the process. And thank you to my fellow graduates. These past 2 years, we have shared the mutual struggles and the happy moments. We survived countless sleepless nights, late practice sessions in the SLC, never-ending exams, hundreds of patient care hours, many summatives, and a pandemic. Congratulations, dearest classmates. We achieved our dream of being a doctor of dental medicine. I hope this is only the beginning of a lifetime of fulfillment and wish you all the best in the bright future ahead of you. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Ms. Julia Geaumont, soon to be Dr. Geaumont, who is a graduate of Bowdoin College in Brunswick, Maine, where she received a Bachelor of Arts degree in 2016. Before enrolling in GSDM, she investigated health disparities in Maine, as well as molecular signaling pathways of tooth development in zebrafish. At GSDM, she was able to pivot and study tooth development in humans, as well as many other things. In addition, she also has had numerous student leadership and community outreach experiences, and after graduation plans to continue as a pediatric dentistry resident at Nova Southeastern University in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. We are honored to have such a distinguished valedictorian for our graduating DMD class. Ms. Geaumont.
Distinguished faculty, dedicated staff, loving family members, and supportive friends, thank you for celebrating with us today. Class of 2021, congratulations. We successfully chased down every last signature we needed. This is probably not the way we expected to or wanted to graduate, but nevertheless, today, we take our over 20-year title of student and exchange it for doctor. Now, for anyone that knows me, I do a couple things excessively. Study, smile, and say thank you. Since the exams are done and my smile's been hidden by a mask for months, I would like to stick to the last thing and say thank you to everyone who helped us get here today. To the amazing front desk staff, thank you for always keeping our clinic schedules filled and helping us with every task or question that we brought to you. Thank you to our patients that trusted us as we made our transitions from typodonts to real people and taught us the importance of appointment reminders. To the dispensary and central sterilization, thank you for always making sure we had the tools we needed, even if we didn't know how to use them. To the assistants, thank you for helping us capture that impossible apex and avoid being named on the unauthorized X-ray email list of shame. To the lab techs, thank you for guiding us through the transformation of our wax rooms and our preps into works of art that our patients were proud to receive. To our faculty, thank you for the endless hours of molding us into the practitioners that we are. It will be impossible to forget the moments when Dr. Malika swept the floor with a broom as we lost our block temps in SLC, when Dr. Noah stepped into the appointment to solve the problem that no one else could, when Dr. Sucre shared pictures of our adorable puppy Oscar to help comfort a patient, or when Dr. Pan's rounds challenged us more than the National Board's Part 2. We appreciate all of you for teaching us dentistry, but more importantly, we admire you for being our everyday role models in our journey of becoming caring and compassionate clinicians. Thank you to our families and friends for being our biggest supporters through some of the most challenging years of our lives. It was the late night phone calls when you told us you can do this, when we didn't believe we could. The home-cooked meals that you made for us after weeks of living off things that could only be warmed up in a library microwave, and when you bravely signed up to be our first patients. The sacrifices you have made in your personal lives have allowed each of us to follow our dreams. Lastly, to the class of 2021, thank you for keeping the past 4 years interesting. Now, for anyone that has been privy to our class group me, you might know that we've had some laughs, some lows, and some oh my god, this is more entertaining than binging Netflix moments. Although these may be the highlights that we remember, it was the times where we supported each other with finding faculty, giving advice on procedures, and warning each other about Pam and her PPE patrols that truly defined us. This support went well beyond the text of this chat when we shared notes, critiqued one another's preps, and assisted our classmates in their first data collections. Together we made it through, and for that, we should be thankful. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you, Dr. Geaumont. Please join me again as we congratulate both our student valedictorians and thank them for their excellent speeches. It is now my pleasure for me to also pivot and introduce our faculty awardees of the Spencer N. Frankel Award for Excellence in Teaching. This award is in honor of the late Dr. Spencer N. Frankel, our second dean of the Henry M. Goldman School of Dental Medicine, who for more than 40 years, 30 of which as dean, provided outstanding leadership for our school. The Frankel Teaching Award recognizes faculty for their teaching excellence and dedication to providing our students with the very best education. This year we are recognizing two recipients, one from the dental school's faculty and one from the medical school's. I am pleased to announce that this year's recipients of the Spencer N. Frankel Award for Excellence in Teaching are Dr. Afsheen Lakhani and Dr. Karen Harnett, both of whom are extraordinary educators, extremely deserving of this award. Dr. Lakhani will be our first speaker. Dr. Afsheen Lakhani is a Clinical Associate Professor of General Dentistry at GSDM. She is also an alumna, having earned both a DMD and Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study from our school. Dr. Lakhani currently serves as a group practice leader in our Predoctoral Patient Treatment Center. Dr. Lakhani is very dedicated to her students, to our school, and to her profession. In addition to her teaching responsibility, she serves on numerous school committees, including most recently co-chairing the Innovation Workgroup of the school's COVID-19 Task Force. And she is also a member of many professional organizations at the state and national levels. She contributes an enormous amount to our school with high energy and an ever-present smile. And I am thrilled to present her with this award. Dr. Lakhani.
Thank you. I know it sounds like a cliche, but I am truly honored and deeply touched to receive this prestigious award. I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Dean Hutter and Dean Leone. My journey at BU started as a student, which transitioned into residency and then a faculty. Over these years, there have been many teachers, mentors, and colleagues who have played an instrumental role in my ongoing learning and success. I cannot take everyone's names today as that list is super long, but I am thinking of all of them today. I'm also very fortunate that some of them are here with me today. So thank you. I am immensely grateful. This award represents excellence, and excellence, I believe, cannot be achieved without teamwork. Therefore, I share this award with my amazing team of practice leaders and all our dedicated faculty members. I also give my humble appreciation to all the staff of the dental school and the whole team of Dental Health Center, which was my first home at BU. Number 7 is considered lucky by many, but for me, that number is 9, as I'm a practice leader for Group 9. And if the former Group 9 practice leader, who is now our director, didn't have the vision that I could fill his, quite literally and figuratively, big shoes, I probably would not be standing here today. Dr. Zweig, I have and will always be grateful to you. Thank you. Next, I would like to thank my family, my parents, for their selfless love, encouragement, support, and blessings, among countless other things. My sisters, who continue to push me to do my best. Well, not just out of love, but because I'm a classic middle child, and it has always been survival of the fittest. My husband, Rahim, who's my pillar of strength, and despite not being a dentist, but being with me for almost 2 decades, he too knows the G.B. Black's classification of caries. And I know that if he ever needs a crown, he can design his own CAD/CAM crown pretty well. My girls, Simal and Sophia, who are my number one supporters and who always let me practice all my presentation and speeches on them. My message to you, my girls, today is, no matter where you are born, what language you speak, what culture you belong to, at the end of the day, if you work hard with integrity and ethics, you can achieve anything. Lastly, and most importantly, to all our students, you complete us. And yes, I did try to quote Tom Cruise from the movie Jerry Maguire, but it's absolutely true. You challenge us. You keep the enthusiasm and the passion going. You inspire us to be better educators every single day. So this is indeed because of you all. As the graduation approaches, we as faculty sometimes starts cautioning you all that you're going to be entering the real world soon. You need to do this by yourself. You're going to be on your own. Don't worry, I'm not going to repeat all that today. But I would say that although you are entering the real world, you are not alone. Remember, you are and will remain a part of our extraordinary BU family. So use these relationships and experiences here at BU as a trampoline to boost your success, to grow your professional network, build an active community of BU alums to support each other and strengthen our institution. I humbly want to say today that I'm a proud product of BU, and you should be too. Thank you again, and congratulations to all the graduates and families of class of 2021.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lakhani, for those inspiring words. The second recipient of this year's Spencer N. Frankel Award, Dr. Karen Harnett, will be joining us virtually. Dr. Harnett is an assistant professor in the Department of Experimental Pharmacology and Therapeutics in the Boston University School of Medicine. She earned the Bachelor of Science in Chemistry degree from Providence College and a PhD in pharmacology from the BU School of Medicine. She is the course director of the GSDM Dental Pharmacology course and also several courses in the medical school. Dr. Harnett's excellence in teaching has been recognized numerous times over her career. Most recently, she was named the 2018 Educator of the Year in the preclinical category at BU School of Medicine. She has demonstrated a high commitment to teaching and learning at GSDM and has worked tirelessly to keep her subject matter timely as well as in-depth. In addition to making herself readily available to students needing extra help and tutoring, I would add that Dr. Harnett has been a role model in teaching and learning excellence in the virtual environment. It is an honor to recognize Dr. Harnett for her contributions to our school. Dr. Harnett.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Dean Ad Interim Leone and Dean Emeritus Hutter. I'm Karen Harnett. I'm an alumna of Boston University, specifically the Department of Pharmacology and Experimental Therapeutics, right here on the same campus. When I first took this job in terms of my role as a director of the dental pharmacology course, my focus was I wanted to do the best job I could for the department. I wanted to represent the Department of Pharmacology well. But as I continued in teaching with your students, these students are really amazing DMD2 students and AS1 students, my focus just shifted to wanting to do the best job I could for them. This pharmacology course is quite fast-paced. It's a dense course, and it takes a lot of work. And when I introduce myself every year to the students and introduce the course, I let them know that we will all be working very hard together to learn pharmacology, and I hope that they learn to like it as much as I do. Last year, the academic year of 2019-20 was like no other, to say the least. It was quite an extraordinary year. One day, our class was held in the auditorium on 670 Albany Street. Next day, I went to a Zoom meeting, like what is Zoom, to try to figure out how to use it. And the following day, I drove into campus thinking it was my last day of teaching live when my guest speaker didn't want to come in due to COVID. So remote teaching began a little bit earlier for me than for others. But what I wanted to do during remote teaching is just trying to stay connected to the students as best as I could. So I sent out extra emails and announcements and provided them with review videos just for me to sort of talk to them through videos, through my reviews of the materials, adding extra questions, adding some extra spreadsheets and such in order for us to all keep up with the material together in a timely fashion as if we were meeting. And I was delighted that the students appreciated my efforts, but I still am keeping in mind that we really all worked hard together. Dr. Leone, you were extremely kind last summer to reach out to me with your Zoom message of thanks last summer. I do appreciate that. And at this time, I'm grateful for the opportunity to still be working with such amazing students this year as well. We're all working hard, still remotely. I'm thankful and honored to be the recipient of this award, the Spencer N. Frankel Award for Excellence in Teaching. Thank you again. I do appreciate the recognition.
Thank you, Dr. Harnett. I am now very pleased to introduce our keynote speaker, Dr. Sheree Farmer-Dixon, Dean of the School of Dentistry at Meharry Medical College. Dr. Farmer-Dixon will be delivering her remarks remotely. Dr. Farmer-Dixon received a bachelor's degree in biology from Mississippi Valley State University and then continued to earn a dental degree from Meharry Medical College. Her intense interest in dental public health led to two more degrees, a Master of Science in Dental Public Health, also at Meharry, and a Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study in Dental Public Health from GSDM, where she remains a proud alumna. Dr. Farmer-Dixon has overcome barriers in race, gender, and academia, becoming the third woman to head the School of Dentistry at Meharry. and that school produces 40% of the nation's currently practicing African-American dentists. She remains one of a few select women to lead in the role as dean of a dental school. In addition to her work at Meharry, Dr. Farmer Dixon also serves her country as a lieutenant colonel in the United States Army Reserve. Dr. Farmer Dixon's academic research focuses on oral health disparities, caries in low-income children, community outreach and intervention, and addressing disparities in minority dental school enrollment. Based on her tireless efforts, Dr. Farmer Dixon is well recognized as a visionary leader and an inspiring role model. And it is a true honor for us to have her join us here today as our GSDM keynote speaker. Dr. Farmer Dixon.
Be not afraid of greatness. Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and others have greatness thrust upon them. These words are penned from William Shakespeare's The Twelfth Night. Today, I congratulate you. I celebrate you in your greatness as well as your many great moments. Please know that I share the proudness and delight that you feel right now as you savor this moment, along with your family, friends, and the faculty, staff, and administration who help you along the way. I would also like to express appreciation to my dear friend, Dr. Hutter, for inviting me to be your commencement speaker. I would also like to congratulate him on his retirement. Today's demonstration of your successes and job well done are not the end of a chapter, but the continuation of a journey of lifelong learning. Notice that I said a journey of lifelong learning. I would like for you to remember several of what I call life's little lessons as you set forth to embark on a journey that will have defining moments for the rest of your life and contribute to your lifelong learning. So, lesson one is, always be open to continued learning. The learning that I am referring to should not be confined to dentistry exclusively. Please do not allow yourself to be placed in a box. Yes, stay abreast of new techniques and approaches in dentistry, but also learn about the communities that you will serve and the policies that will not only impact you, but will impact the communities that you will serve. Do not be a silent observer of social injustice. Be sensitive, aware, and engaged in matters to eliminate health disparities and remove barriers while creating health equity for all. Eradicate social injustice and racial inequities. I am sure that your success journey began as mine. It began the day you were born. Growing up as a girl in Indianola, Mississippi, I am a third-generation college graduate from a family of educators. My parents, Mr. and Mrs. Willie Farmer, gave me a foundation of love and support. My father, Willie, was an elementary school principal, and my mother, Betty, is an English and literature college professor at our alma mater, Mississippi Valley State University. My parents ensured that my sister and I were well-rounded and active in the community. They set expectations of high academic excellence and encouraged me to be actively engaged in school activities as well as the church. They stressed the importance of hard work, the value of a good education, and the importance of reaching back and helping others. Each experience presented life's lessons and teachable moments that laid the foundation and provided the fortitude for what the next several years of my life would bring and helped to mold me into adulthood. I am forever grateful for their unconditional love and support. And that brings me to lesson two. Always acknowledge, be grateful, and thank those who help you along the way. Remember, no one makes it through life alone. While in high school, I had the wonderful opportunity to participate in a summer science program that helped to define my trajectory. I had the opportunity to shadow various health professionals. And when I rotated in a dental clinic in a community health center, that left an indelible impression. A woman came in and the dentist was able to restore her smile. Seeing the woman's reaction and how it changed her whole countenance and how she felt about herself made me want to become a dentist so that I could have that type of impact on the lives of others. So it was off to dental school, and my dental quest began. The journey continued with me graduating and continuing to make a difference as I fulfilled my dream of becoming a doctor of dental surgery. Dental school taught me many life's lessons, many of which I'm sure you learned during your dental matriculation. These included agility, patience, adaptability, perseverance, compassion, caring, leadership, and service. These would be lessons to live by, and that brings me to lesson three. Take from dental school both the good and the bad. Reflect on the positive, and remember to make lemonade out of lemons. Instill a sense of patience, compassion, and humbleness as you provide supreme quality care to your patients. Be a leader and mentor in your community by giving back to help and inspire the next generation. Dental school also exposed me to the world of public health, which I love. It was several of my dental school faculty who had completed their postgraduate training at BU's School of Dental Medicine who shared with me its rich history and told me of the long-standing relationship between Meharry's Dental School and BU's School of Dental Medicine. I stand on the shoulders of Meharry graduates like Dr. Edwin Hines and Dr. June Owens, who completed their pediatric dentistry residency training at BU, and Dr. Barbara Jones, who completed her periodontic training at BU as well. And the list goes on. To follow in their footsteps and complete my public health residency training solidified me as a public health dentist. I am truly appreciative of the support that was given from the faculty and staff and the friendships that I established during this process. My academic and professional journey led me to become dean and serve as one of two African-American women deans of U.S. dental schools and rank among the 11 women who are among the deans of the 68 dental schools in the U.S. Has it always been easy? No. Have there been challenges? Absolutely yes. The true test, however, has been how I chose to cope with and overcome those challenges, which brings us to lesson four. How you deal with each challenge defines you and turns you into the person you will become. Now, we have all been consumed by the pandemic and the many challenges that it has brought. It has also brought with it a renewed awareness of the health disparities that exist, especially among people of color. African Americans comprise approximately 13% of the U.S. population, but account for an estimated 24% of all COVID-related deaths. And in the midst of the pandemic, the deaths of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and the many others has created a heightened awareness that racial injustices are still rampant. The recent surge on the Capitol, as well as the recent attack, have also demonstrated the political unrest in our country and the importance of behavioral health. Now, while the vaccine and access across the country is helping to reduce the pandemic, African Americans and other people of color continue to represent a low percentage of those vaccinated. The level of distrust and hesitancy as a result of some historical experiences, such as the Tuskegee syphilis study, the story of Henrietta Lacks, and others are relevant. I want to challenge you to search your soul in the midst of the pandemic and in the midst of social injustice and health disparities and racial inequalities. I challenge you to search your soul to answer this question: what is your PCR? I'm not referring to the PCR or polymerase chain reaction test that has been recognized as the most reliable in testing for COVID-19. I'm asking you, what is your purpose, commitment, and the results? During this pandemic, my PCR was repurposed, and I was asked to lead and have oversight of the COVID-19 testing that we would be conducting in the community. This included setup, logistics of operations, and data collection. Of course, I said yes. First, how do you tell your boss, the president, no? But seriously, the organizational skills, community engagement, and leadership skills that I had learned growing up in Mississippi, developed during dental school, and enhanced over the years as an officer in the United States Army Reserve, and in my various teaching and administrative capacities, let me know that I was up to the challenge. What I did not anticipate was the expansion to having oversight of the three sites for the city of Nashville, having to provide this leadership for over a year, and now adding assisting with management of administering the vaccine throughout the city, while still serving as dean and all of its responsibilities. This challenge, however, created an opportunity for other healthcare professionals to understand and appreciate the significant value and benefits that dentists could and did bring to addressing the pandemic, and the value and impact of interprofessional collaboration. Never compromise your worth and the value you bring to dental care and also to overall health care. I reflect on this past year with an attitude of gratitude when I look at the diverse expertise of people who came together and collaborated with a common goal for the sake of humanity. So the question is, what is your PCR? In the midst of a pandemic, you are like the rungs on a ladder. You are strong and maintained your position, and you were fearless at a time and place where we clearly were faced with a lot of unknowns. Maintain a level of strength to overcome obstacles. Maintain a posture of professionalism, ethics, and high moral standards. As you graduate today, I challenge you with lesson 5, to know your PCR. I hope that your purpose will be to uphold the dental oath of doing good and no harm, and maintaining professionalism and ethics. I hope that you will have a commitment to support the institution like BU, the school that helped you obtain your degree and helped you to become a dentist. I hope you will also have a commitment to mentor the next generation. And I hope that you will let your actions result in making the world a better place by helping to eliminate social injustice, racial inequities, and health disparities. Again, I say, know your purpose, your commitment, and your results. In the words of Judy Garland, always be a first-rate version of yourself instead of a second-rate version of somebody else. Remember and live by these 5 lessons. Lesson 1, always be open to continued learning. Lesson 2, always acknowledge, be grateful, and thank those who help you along the way. Lesson 3, take from dental school both the good and the bad, making lemonade out of lemons. Lesson 4, how you deal with each challenge defines you and turns you into the person you will become. And lesson 5, know your PCR. Congratulations, graduates. I am elated to call you doctor and welcome you to the profession. Go forth, prosper, make a difference in the communities that you will serve.
Thank you, Dr. Farmer Dixon. And now it is time for our predoctoral and postdoctoral graduates to recite in unison the professional oath.
Now, having been admitted to the profession of dentistry, I pledge myself to the service of humanity, my patients, my community, and my profession. I will use my skills to serve all in need with openness of spirit and without bias. The health and well-being of my patients will be my first consideration. I will hold in confidence all that my patients entrust to me. I will not subordinate the dignity of any person to monetary, scientific, or political ends. I recognize that I have responsibilities to my community to promote its welfare and to speak out against injustice. The high regard of my profession is born of society's trust in its practitioners.
I will strive to merit that trust.
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 I will conduct myself with the highest ethical and professional behavior in the classroom, the clinic, and all areas of my life. I will promote the integrity of my profession with honest and respectful relations with other health professionals. I will strive to advance my profession by seeking new knowledge and by re-examining the ideas and practices of the past. I assume these responsibilities knowing that their fulfillment relies on my own good health. I ask that my colleagues be attentive to my well-being as I will be to theirs. I will seek to improve my practice by maintaining my skills and addressing my mistakes.
I take this oath freely and upon my honor.
I take this oath freely and upon my honor.
I take this oath freely and upon my honor.
I take this oath freely and upon my honor.
Well done. Thank you, graduates. Before we conclude, there are three additional points I wish to make. Don't worry, I'll be brief. First, we must acknowledge that progress in life is a generational happenstance. We would be remiss if we did not also commend the families of our graduates for the support they have provided. Without their uncompromising love, moral and ethical guidance, and, in many cases, financial support, our graduates would not be here today. Graduates, I ask you to please say thank you to these very special people in your own special ways. Second, we must also acknowledge Dean Jeffrey W. Hutter, who retired this year after more than 24 years of service to the school, the past 13 years as dean. Graduates, Dr. Hutter was your dean during your time here. I know that he is proud of the class of 2021, his last class as dean, and that he cherishes all the years that he and his wife, Kathleen, got to know you in your class and in previous graduating classes. We pay tribute to Dr. Hutter for his prescience in establishing a vision for the school, for his fortitude in turning that vision into a reality, and for his courage in stepping away after a job very well done. On a personal note, I am grateful for his mentorship and guidance of me, and hope that in some small way, I can begin to fill the very large shoes that he left and did not take with him to Hawaii. We wish Dean and Mrs. Hutter all the best. And finally, I return to our metaphor of the journey. Graduates, of course, that journey continues for you, each of you. Each of you will decide if you hurriedly go from point A to point B, and then to point C, etc., without pausing along the way, or if you will take the time to savor the parts in between. There is a lot quickly coming at you. Your careers will be young. Your marriages will be or are already young. Your children will be or are already young. Your parents are or will be not quite so young. And your friends will be, more or less, as young or as old as you are. Life will present you many choices to make, and each of you will decide how you make them. Some might reframe the metaphor and say that life is a marathon, with hills to go up and hills to go down. If true, then it is my sincerest hope that each of you will pace yourselves accordingly as you strive to complete your own professional and personal finish lines. Please all rise as I ask Reverend Hill to give us the benediction.
With thanks to Dean Leone and congratulations to our graduates, we pause for a word of blessing and a prayer and benediction. The blessing, let love be genuine, hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good, love one another with mutual affection, outdo one another in showing honor, never lag in zeal, be ardent in spirit, serve the Lord, rejoice in your hope, be patient in tribulation, be constant in prayer, contribute to the needs of the saints, practice hospitality. And the prayer. Tireless guardian on our way, thou hast kept us well this day. While we thank thee, we request care continued, pardon, rest. Amen.
Thank you again, Reverend Hill. Dearest graduates, families, friends, and all of the GSDM community, this concludes our graduation convocation for the class of 21. On behalf of the Henry M. Goldman School of Dental Medicine, go forth, be safe, be healthy, be happy, and be prosperous. Thank you.